Breaking overnight, the Coalition has claimed a decisive victory in the Fadden by-election, delivering Peter Dutton a much-needed boost. Live 2 Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards. Eliza, good morning. There was a small swing to the opposition.
That's right, Soph. This is a safe Liberal National seat in Queensland, so the party was always expected to retain it. Overnight, Cam Corwell did just that, beating out 13 candidates, including Labor's Leticia Del Fabbro. Importantly, though, the LNP increased its margin in Fadden. We're expecting to see a swing of around 2% in this by-election. So that will provide Peter Dutton with a confidence boost that his message on cost of living is cutting through, particularly after a disastrous result for him in the Aston by-election in April. His message for party faithful last night reflected that, insisting the Coalition is on a path back to government.
That the work that we've done in the first 12 months to make sure that we work together in a united way, to make sure that we adhere to our values, to make sure that we present the manifesto, the alternative to the Australian public, that is what we're working on, because there is a better way for our country. Our country is going in the wrong direction under Anthony Albanese.
Sophie, Labor says the result isn't a surprise because this is a blue ribbon seat and momentum typically doesn't go the government's way at a by-election. They won't be too worried about this result, but they'll be paying attention to the message sent on cost of living.
Eliza, thank you.
Welcome back to Weekend Today. Thanks for your company this morning. Peter Dutton will be feeling sweet relief this morning after the LNP candidate scored a win in a crucial by-election overnight. Concerns over the rising cost of living seemingly outweighing any anger the community might have had against outgoing MP Stuart Robert over the robo-debt disaster. Let's bring in today's talkers, Nationals leader David Littleproud, who's in Ryford, Queensland, and Triple M commentator Gus Warland. Good morning to you both. David, this is a good win for the opposition. What do you take away from this result?
Yeah, it was a solid win and a swing to us. And I think it's a reflection of the pain that families are feeling out there. Households are feeling this. And all that Anthony Albanese has been able to do in 15 months is drive up everyone's cost of living and divide the country. And so it's an important message for the government around their energy policy, this reckless race to 82% by 2030, going from just 26%. There's no sensible policy that's bringing down those pressures, not just on your power bill, but also on your food bill, because food processors are paying sometimes three times, sometimes four times more what they were 12 months ago. And they've got to pass that on to you. And your mortgages are up higher because of the spending in this government. So it's not about pumping more money into the economy. It's just using some common sense, pulling the levers that actually bring down inflationary pressure, whether it be on power, food, or on your mortgage. And I think this is a very big message to Anthony Albanese and his government that they're out of touch and they need to get in touch real quick. Otherwise, come another 15 months and we're up, they might feel the pain.
Gus, we have to be clear, this was a safe LNP seat anyway. It was never really going to go the other way. But do you think there is a warning for Anthony Albanese and the Labor Party here on the cost of living?
Yeah, I think so. And I think, obviously, in the last 15 months or so, you know, he's done a pretty good job as a general rule and he's got some stuff done. But like anything, it's a checks and balance situation. And they were going to lose that seat anyway. That was a safe Liberal seat. But just a little bit of a check to say, you know what, mate, you can't just do whatever you want to do. There's a lot of stuff out there that people are worrying about. Everyone that talks to us on Triple M, that's their main worry, how they're going to pay their groceries, how they're going to pay their petrol, the real simple stuff that in Australia we shouldn't really have to be worrying about. So, yeah, an opportunity for a recheck for the government to realise that it's not all going to be plain sailing.
No, absolutely not.
Voters in the federal seat of Fadden have swung to the opposition, prompting Peter Dutton to declare people are, quote, fed up with the cost of living pressures. Live 2 Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards in Canberra for us. Eliza, the Coalition was always expected to retain the seat, though.
Yeah, Sophie, this result in a blue ribbon seat is no surprise. The Coalition's Cameron Caldwell easily winning this contest and securing a small swing of around 2% to his party. So there were plenty of celebrations at the Liberal function overnight. This win is a confidence boost for Peter Dutton that his messaging on cost of living is cutting through.
People are hurting at the moment and the Labor economic experiment is failing Australians. Labor's energy experiment is failing Australians.
The government will no doubt listen to what voters in Fadden have said on cost of living dissatisfaction. Labor won't be overly concerned about this loss, though, Sophie.
OK, Eliza, thank you.
Queensland.
Celebrations this morning for the Liberal National Party retaining the safe Gold Coast seat of Fadden in a by-election triggered by that resignation of MP Stuart Robert.
Peter Dutton saying it shows Labor's economic management is failing Australians. Let's bring in Chief Political Correspondent for the Saturday Paper, Karen Middleton in Canberra. Good morning to you, Karen. Both sides are trying to claim this a bit. The opposition says it's a win. The government says, well, a real victory would have been bigger than this. What do you think the result shows?
Well, it's interesting, Jane. At the election last year, Labor shaved 3.6% off the margin that the LNP had in this seat. And what the LNP's done overnight is shave some of that, well, bring some of that back. It looks like 2 to 3%, might be more. So we're getting back to the status quo. So the Labor government is saying, oh, anything short of a 4% swing in favour of the LNP really is an embarrassment for Peter Dutton. Mm. But I'd say they've done reasonably well. And if you look at Peter Dutton's face, he doesn't look embarrassed to me.
Well, I mean, it is worth noting they tipped in a lot of cash, $600K into the campaign. Is Peter Dutton's leadership a little safer this morning?
I think he's a happy man. He was first through the door before even the candidate, Cameron Caldwell, last night. And look at the size of that smile. He is pretty happy. Mm. I think if this hadn't gone like this, if this had shaved some a margin off the LNP further, he would have been under some pressure. So even though this was all about cost of living and a number of other local issues, it was also a bit about Peter Dutton's leadership. He would have been under pressure. I think he's relieved and happy that he's got this result today.
Well, cost of living being a key feature of this campaign, we've seen some huge changes this week at the Reserve Bank of Australia, some new rules being put in place, as well as the announcement of a new chief. Do you think the government has used Philip Lowe as a bit of a scapegoat here?
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? There's been a lot of attention on Philip Lowe. Now the Treasurer is saying what a great bloke he is, how impeccably he's behaved since the transition to a new governor. He would have known Philip Lowe for a while that this was on the cards, and he has been very dignified about this. But certainly the government wants to put a bit of distance between itself and the bank's decisions on interest rates. The new governor, Michelle Bullock, is going to have to do press conferences after these decisions, so she's going to be answerable directly to the people via journalists for each decision, and that's an interesting move by the government to make sure that the bank stays accountable for what it decides to do.
It will be an interesting plane trip when Philip Lowe and Jim Chalmers jump on that plane for the G20 finance meeting. What's on the agenda? How will that ride be?
Yeah, a bit awkward, I reckon. I mean, Jim Chalmers says it won't be awkward. And to be fair, as I say, I think the current governor has known this was coming. So it's not a massive surprise in the last couple of days. But they're off to the G20 finance ministers. One of the things Australia wants there is to talk about a minimum global rate of tax. The Australian government is frustrated that big corporations are operating here but setting up headquarters in countries that have lower tax rates and paying tax there so that they're avoiding paying higher rates here. They want a minimum rate across the board, so that stops happening, and that would mean revenue for Australia.
Speaking of trips abroad, a trip to China could be on the cards for the Prime Minister. What progress has been made there this week?
Well, it's a little bit two steps forward, one step back, isn't it? The Foreign Minister has met her counterpart in the past few days, but it does look as though there's some frustration that China has not quite accelerated the end of those punishing arrangements on Australian commodities that the Australian government is looking for. And I think there's now a suggestion that visit might be delayed if there's not more progress to see our goods flowing properly back into China. So a bit unsure exactly what the agenda looks like. They said it would be this year. Maybe it still will be this year, but they're looking for some sign from China before they commit.
All right, Karen Middleton there in Canberra. Always good to hear your point of view. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.